Welcome to the new series on AWS Cloud Development Kit. In this series, we are going to see how we can create AWS resources using AWS Console, and then how we can automate the resources which we have created manually in AWS Console using AWS CDK framework. The prerequisite for this course is we should have AWS account, we should know the basic cloud, and we should have good hands-on on any of the programming language, which include JavaScript, TypeScript, Python, C#, F#, Java, and Go. In this series, we are only going to focus on five languages: JavaScript, TypeScript, Python, C#, and Go language. You can also write the same kind of code in F# as well as Java language. If you are new to AWS world, you need to create your AWS account. For creating an AWS account, first you need to go to AWS console. From here, you are going to click on create an AWS account. You need to fill out a form, and that form include the email address, password, confirm password, and the name of AWS account. You also need to ask you a couple of more information about the country for which we are going to create this account: address, city, postal code, state. This entire process is also going to ask you the billing information, where we need to put the credit card information or debit card information. When everything is successful, it's going to send a SMS on the registered mobile number. Once we verify the number, it is going to ask us what kind of support we want. If you are new to AWS world, it is recommended that you should go with a basic support. Once you complete all the steps, then you can log in to AWS using a root user. Once you provide the email address and password, then you will be navigated to AWS console. This is the AWS console. After getting AWS Management Console, we need to configure the AWS profile. For configuring AWS profile, we need to perform three steps. First, we need to create an identity and access management user, IAM user. Then we need to install AWS CLI. And then we need to configure AWS CLI. For IAM user configuration, first we need to go to AWS Management Console. Then we need to go to services. And here we need to select security, identity, and compliance service. In security, identity, and compliance, we can see IAM user. We can mark as a favorite. We can click on IAM and navigate to IAM page, or we can also search the name IAM in global search. Here we need to select users. For creating a user, we need to click on add users. Here we need to add the name of user. I am going to put my name, Durga. It is going to ask us what kind of access we want. In our case, let's say we only want a programmatically access, and this is will be useful when we are to deploy anything using CDK framework. And this password-based access is required for this AWS management console. So I'm going to enable both the things. If you are creating a role or user only for your CI and CD, then please make sure that this password-based authentication should be disabled. Since I selected password-based authentication, it's going to ask me to auto-generate the password or put a custom password. I will go with auto-generated password. And once the password has been generated, whether the user has to change the password in first login or not, this is checkbox is for. And the next permission, we need to create a group because we don't have any group. In this case, we need to assign the roles or policies to that group. In my case, I'm going to use this series for multiple projects. That's why I'm going to add the administrator access as a policy. But in production, please make sure that only use policies which is required. Don't give the administrator access policies. Otherwise, the user or the group which has been created, it has more rights than expected. I'm going to put the name of group will be admin group. And then we need to text. This is optional. Do we need to add the tags? It's always kind of a good practice to add a tag. Here I will put So this will be very useful if I want to see, okay, what are the users group which I have created manually. Then everything looks good. Create user. The user has been created. Once the user has been created, we'll get four things: user, access key ID, secret access key, as well as password. The user and password will be used when we want to log into this AWS Management Console with the IAM user. The access key ID as well as the secret access key will be used by AWS CLI, as well as it is going to be used by our CI/CD pipeline for deploying the services. The next step is to install AWS CLI. For AWS CLI, please refer this link. It has all the instructions which is required for macOS, Linux, as well as for Windows. For macOS as well as for Windows, we have this application which will help us to install this AWS CLI. For Linux, we need to run few command for installing this AWS CLI. Once you have completed this AWS CLI installation, you can verify the CLI version by running this command. And it will give you information about what is the current CLI version. Now the next step is to configure AWS profile. For configuring AWS profile, we need to run AWS configure. We can put the name of profile. Here I'm going to put simply server list. This is a logical name. You can put any name you want. It is going to ask us three things. First is the access key ID, which is this one. Then it is going to ask secret access key, which is this one. And the third thing is the region which we want. So we can go with the default region. So profile has been configured. That's it for this video. In the next video, we are going to see how we can publish a static website on AWS S3 using AWS Management Console. And we are also going to see how we can automate the entire process which are going to perform on AWS Management Console using AWS CDK. Thank you very much for watching this video.